Another episode of Intense Wrestling's Genesis. We've got some great action for you tonight. Hot off of Regal Rampage, we're now going to be working on the 2-month build for Total Annihilation. But before all that, we're going to have a United Kingdom Championship match. It's a big rematch. The former champion Donovan Hazard takes on the current champion Ethan the Hunter. This is going to be good. Two big, vicious competitors. We've got the seemingly unstoppable Donovan Hazard. Someone who you have to seemingly just kill in order to stop him. You can't knock him down. I don't know if Ethan's going to be able to do it.
From Knoxville, Tennessee, Donovan Hazard.
I don't know if Ethan's going to be able to beat Donovan on his own. Donovan was only beaten because there were four other men. Donovan is seemingly unstoppable. It is terrifying to watch him in the ring. Ethan the Hunter might be one of the best people to take him on. Ethan the Hunter has proven many times in the past to be a very capable competitor, was once nearly Limitless champion at one point. But Donovan Hazard has been on such a, he's had a streak basically lately. Like, he has proven himself to be nearly unstoppable. So I don't know if Ethan is going to be able to stop this man.
From Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, Ethan the Hunter.
This is genuinely a case of the unstoppable force meets the immovable object. You have Ethan the Hunter with some of the most vicious strikes on Genesis. You know, those hard-hitting punches, as well as that ability to choke his opponents out with the guillotine choke. As I've mentioned before, if he locks that in, you are either tapping out or you're passing out. And he's up against a brick wall of meat in Donovan Hazard. This is going to be down to the wire, I feel. Very close competition, and this is why the United Kingdom Championship is such a beloved title now. The likes of Wade Danielson, VVC, Walter Abbott, Donovan Hazard, and Ethan the Hunter have helped to elevate this title to new levels. It may not be the top title in Genesis, but damn, is it clear that it is still a title with value, with prominence. And that is why they fight for it. Sure, these men one day will want to be Limitless champion, but here and now, they know that this is still an incredibly good place to be. And that was a big response there. Big set of cheers for the current champion, Ethan the Hunter, in his first big championship defense of that United Kingdom title. Oh, this is going to be... You can see Donovan Hazard not even looking at the belt. His eyes are focused on Ethan right now. I do not know... I could not put money on either of these two in this one. Like, I think Donovan's going to win overall with moves like that. But this is two top-of-the-line competitors. Two people who I could see going for the Limitless title in the future. Oh, just going at it. Coming to blows. And, there's some of those punches, some of those vicious punches from Ethan. And Donovan, as tough as he is, definitely going to be feeling that. Oh, taking him down, and look at that. Oh, and again, just punching away. There's nothing pretty about that, but that's the thing. Ethan, he isn't focused on being the most fantastical performer. He's not looking to be like Samuel and do like 50 flips in the air. He's looking to be just fully effective. That's what made him once nearly limitless champion, only falling to Ace the Tank Barkey, who made his grand return actually in the Regal Rampage match. Well, not in the Regal Rampage match, but it was at the Regal Rampage pay-per-view. And that was a very big deal. Now, we haven't heard yet about what the plan is. Obviously, Ace wants to get his hands on the Crusher. We'll have to wait to hear more about that. But right now, this match is getting vicious in a hurry. Ooh, Donovan's only staggers not knocked over, and now rushing over. Ooh, but Ethan getting out of the way. Good work there. But Donovan not phased, sending Ethan tumbling to the outside. Now they're brawling on the outside. Oh man, look at them go. Ooh! Oh wow! Not giving each other an inch here. They know that this is a dangerous environment to be in. The outside of the ring is just littered with ways to hurt your opponent. All the more, that concrete floor just barely protected. That steel barricade only has a thin layer of cloth. Now they're back in the ring, of course, so they're back in more of a safer environment, but still, you can't say it's fully safe when you got people like this clubbing the hell out of each other. Oh my god! And again, back to brutalizing the skull of Donovan Hazard. Oh man, bringing Donovan to his feet, but a fireman's carry allows Donovan to have the time to spring back into action, and hopefully for him, he'll be able to make a comeback here. Oh, as he takes it into the corner, rushing over. Oh, and a big clothesline. Irish whip again, and another clothesline, not giving even a second. Ooh! That side slam connecting, and now Donovan in the driver's seat in full control. Oh, and there's the big, brutal super kick from Donovan Hazard. And he's not done yet. I think I know what he's going to go for. The atomic bomb. If that connects, then this match is as good as over. Here it comes. The atomic bomb is about to drop. Oh, an explosive impact right there. And I think Ethan's done. I think he's done. Going for that pinfall now. One, two. Oh, and a kick out at two. Ethan Hunter staying in this one. That is remarkable. The atomic bomb, maybe not as effective as the guillotine choke, but it is still a vicious move, not one you want to be taking. The gamma spike though, that is the real, like, that is the mega death finisher. Like, you get it by that, you're done. Right now, Donovan Hazard just working Ethan the Hunter over. Oh man, you can just see Ethan. Like, that's not gonna take Ethan out, but definitely enacting some pain, and Ethan having to work hard there to get out of it using that stunner. Oh, now working the arm over. And the thing about this is, Ethan, we've seen him, he's capable of submissions, and so I imagine working the limbs over gives him that little bit of an advantage. Oh, gonna go for a pin here. One, no, only a one count. And this is what I was on about. Donovan Hazard is so durable, so tanky, that he is just, it just takes so much to stop him. Oh, and boom, slamming Ethan down. Like, this is the thing about Donovan, is that we have seen all of the stuff that he could be put through in those five-man matches, and he is damn near unstoppable. Oh, look at this, lifting up Ethan. Driving him down. And look at that. The fans are in disbelief. After all the beating that Donovan has taken, the fact that he is still going. Like, these men. Oh my goodness, look at this. Look at this. Boom! Oh my God, we could be about to see it. Now that is normally a sign that Ethan is looking to put this away. Oh God, he's choking out Donovan Hazard here. Choking him out. And that is vicious right there from Ethan. Donovan's getting right back up. Oh, and again a big slam. Donovan, I think he realized Ethan wants to put this away. And Donovan knows that he needs to really work Ethan over, needs to get Ethan out of it. So that, you know, because if Ethan locks in that guillotine choke, as tough as Donovan is, I don't think Donovan will have an answer. 99% of people do not have an answer for that guillotine choke. Oh! Nice work there by Ethan the Hunter. Big punch. Oh, and a return. That knee strike. Oh, but that uppercut staggers. Oh, and again, and that knocked Donovan over. Going for another pin here. One, two. No, it's not enough. It's not enough. Donovan is still going. But now Ethan, as he gets up, here it comes. The guillotine choke. He's looking for it. He's looking for it. He's got it. It's locked in. And I think Donovan, as tough as he is going to have to tap if he doesn't want to pass out. There we have it. Donovan, as tough as he is, he knew that the game was over. At that point, he was not breaking out of that guillotine choke. Donovan is smart. He's experienced. He knew at that point there was no point in continuing to fight it. The match was over the moment that guillotine choke was locked in. And Ethan the Hunter has cemented himself as our UK champion. And I imagine it is going to take a lot to get that off him. If he is able to beat Donovan Hazard, it's going to be very tricky to beat Ethan. Man, oh man. What a performance. I am very happy with how that turned with that match. Just like I said, that was really the case of the unstoppable force meets the immovable object. And in this case, the immovable object broke from the force of Ethan the Hunter. My, oh my. Brutal, absolutely brutal. And that's what we love to see here in Intense Wrestling. It's some of the best wrestlers in the world going at it with, and even for the secondary titles, you are guaranteed to see wrestlers putting their lives on the line because these tunnels mean that much to them. Now we move on to the next match. We're not wasting any time here.
From Taipei, Taiwan, it's the Tank Party.
Oh, here comes the most anticipated return to VGIW in a long time. Well, at least for Genesis. Mountop's got Herman's return, and Genesis has the return of this man. Possibly one of the greatest wrestlers VGIW has ever seen. Here comes Ace the Tank Barkey. Oh, this man is nearly unstoppable. The only reason he was gone was because of that debilitating neck, was because of that neck injury that was given to him by the Crusher. But he is back, and I know that he wants the Crusher's head. He wants to get revenge for what the Crusher did to him. And I've got to say this, Crusher may be hiding behind that first blood stipulation, but Ace would definitely be someone who would be, like, I don't think Ace really cares what stipulation the Crusher has. Ace could dish out so much punishment to the Crusher. Though for tonight at least, before we hear more about the status of the Crusher and Ace, we're going to have the Ace in his first match back against Samuel the Savior. Samuel, a great high flyer. Maybe not one of the highest tier competitors, but Samuel always up for a good fight. His speed and agility, his acrobatics allow him to be a tricky competitor, and he's very good at getting upsets. So there's a very real possibility that Ace is going to make this comeback and lose his first match back, because Samuel right now is just using that speed. Oh, but Ace now looking to try grind Samuel to a halt here. Irish whip against the ropes. Oh, look at that dodge. And right now, Samuel doing very well at just making this very tricky for Ace. Oh, there's a Texas Cloverleaf right there from Samuel the Savior. Now, we've been seeing this more and more ever since Samuel won via a Dragon Sleeper at the Halloween episode. Samuel has been, you know, not only has he been one of the biggest high flyers in Intense Wrestling, but he's also been, like, utilizing more submissions. I think he's realized a potential avenue to make himself even more, like, capable. Oh my god! That was incredible! Imagine that, one of the most capable high flyers. I'll just finish my sentence. Imagine one of the most capable high flyers adopting submission work. That could be brilliant. Speaking of submission work, though, Ace is very familiar with submissions. You know, he's the only man in the entirety of VGIW that has 4 finishers. And I'm not even, like, I should point out, obviously, in-game, you can only have 2 finishers. But in this one moveset that has barely ever changed ever since his debut, he has somehow, some way, gathered 4 different ways to finish his opponent. Ways that have consistently worked. There's the burning hammer, which he takes you into the corner, drops you on the back of your head, and you are done. You are done. There's the Kimura, where he can break your arm if you're not careful. There's the cattle mutilation, which has tapped out many an opponent and was his 3rd finisher. And the most recent one he had was when he won the Limitless title, before he eventually lost it, was when he brought in the Lion Tamer. The thing with Ace's moveset, and I hate to be ignoring Samuel here, who's right now winning, but the thing about Ace's moveset, for those who aren't aware, is his moveset has barely changed since 2K18. There have been obviously some slight changes, like, and now we can dive from the top rope, but the changes are genuinely, you could probably count them on both hands. It's very slight, very small amounts of changes, and yet Ace continues to pull out new moves like a buckle bomb. I don't believe I've ever seen him do a buckle bomb before. The fact that he keeps pulling out new moves and the very slight amount of new moves in his arsenal means that Ace continues to pull new moves out of the hat. A seemingly endless pool of moves. That makes Ace one of the most vicious, intimidating wrestlers on the roster. Oh! Samuel there tried to get at Ace, but Ace just knocked him silly. And now Ace dishing some vicious punches there. Oh, but Samuel, not dissuaded, goes for an Irish whip. Oh, no, that is tragic for Samuel. Ace just barely got out of the way of that one. Now dragging Samuel. Gonna go for a pin, but I don't think that's gonna do it. Only a 1 count. Yeah, Samuel only fell over. That was never gonna be a 3 count. Oh, but Ace now wrapping those legs around the torso, squeezing the ribs, making it harder to breathe. And Samuel knows he needs to break out because that is going to do damage to the torso. Ah, into the corner now. What is Ace going to do here? Oh, I think I know what he's going to do, and this is going to be very vicious. He's looking for that burning hammer. I could guarantee it. And if it connects, this is over. Oh, good lord. We haven't seen this in a while. Oh, Samuel. Oh, my God. Oh, one of the most vicious, brutal finishers in Intense Wrestling. 1, 2, 3. Welcome back to VGIW Ace the Tank Barkey. Oh, man. That was brilliant. That was an absolutely stellar match there. Samuel doing as he usually does, very entertaining, win or lose. Samuel's always a joy to watch in that ring, bringing a set of high-flying flips and maneuvers that you don't see from anyone else. But against the likes of Ace the Tank Barkey, with his own unique, varied moveset, was able to keep up that aggression that we have been used to seeing from Ace. Ace has never been one for taking anyone's ball. And if this performance is anything to go by, his ring rust is quickly dissipating, and he will soon be ready for the Crusher. We just need that go-ahead from General Manager Jim Blanc to have that match take place. And that is going to be a match for the ages. Oh, it's so good. We got Herman on Mountaintop, we got Ace on Genesis. The big returns are meaning that VGIW is getting better and better. Oh, this is going to be good. What is going to follow up such an amazing match? Well, next up, it's going to be a big old feud, the first of the series of seven. It's Leo versus the Golden Phoenix. Now, Leo and Golden Phoenix were formerly a tag team. They were tag team champions at one point.
From Lagos, Nigeria, Leo!
But after they lost the title, Leo soon felt that he was being held back by the Golden Phoenix and attacked the Golden Phoenix. Now, the Golden Phoenix back then was known as the Golden Eagle, but he has come back, reborn as the Golden Phoenix, risen again from the ashes, and wants to get revenge. He wants to show, he wants to prove Leo wrong, that he is better than his former tag team partner.
From Guadalajara, Mexico, El Phoenix Dorado, the Golden Phoenix.
And this is gonna be good. Two of the big masked wrestlers of Intense Wrestling, former tag team champions, looking to make their names known on Genesis. And, well, right now, to make their names known, they're going to have to do it by going through each other in this series of seven. This is the first match in that series of seven. And I've got to say, this could very well get... This could get brutal in a right hurry. And Golden Phoenix in the ring. What an impact. What a entrance. Leo... not much of a high flyer. His offense is very much, his power, scrappy. He is, despite Leo being smaller, he is far stronger than you would maybe think. Golden Phoenix, more of that traditional offense that you would expect from Lucha Wrestling. Great high flyer, great acrobat in that ring. Very capable, moves around like a superhero almost. Ooh! Nice duck under. Oh, bloody hell. And that super kick from Leo might be showing the way this match will pan out. Right now, Leo not wasting any time here. Just getting right to work on the Golden Phoenix. You can see that there is no love lost here. Oh, this is... he's just getting to work. He is not giving the Golden Phoenix even a second. Golden Phoenix is right back up. But look at this! Just going right back onto the Golden Phoenix. Oh my goodness! And right, we've seen the Golden Phoenix very capable in that ring. Very much gotten some nice wins. And was nearly, did get pretty far in the second Limitless Championship hunt. And a nice kick there, taking the legs out. Leo didn't get as far, but Leo has proven himself in the early goings here. Oh my god! That he's very much not to be messed with. But right now, Golden Phoenix now taking control, going for a pinfall here. It's a little early, I think. Yep, just a one count. And now the Golden Phoenix in control of the match. And look at, Leo's getting right back up. Golden Phoenix could be in trouble here. Oh, never mind, goes for a Northern Lights suplex. Good work there. And now you can see there, Irish Whip into the corner. Oh, and what a drop kick. Leo getting right back up, but he gets caught by the blows from the Golden Phoenix. And a big knee to the face. And now we're seeing here, Leo and Golden Phoenix just showing each other what they're capable of. How much they've changed since those tag team days. That crucifix connects. Now stomping away at Leo as he goes up to the top rope. Golden Phoenix about to do some major high flying here. Oh my god, that's all like halfway across the ring. A frog splash connects. That was incredible. Viva la raza, one. Oh, only a one count though. Oh my god, that was incredible. That was like halfway across the ring. And a big neck breaker right there. Oh man, oh man. And now standing moonsault. Oh, this is what I was on about. Like Golden Phoenix, one of the other big high flyers of Genesis. Oh my god! Oh, what in the world? That was incredible! Oh, and it really shows the difference in the offense. Two, oh, and a two count. Leo, far more gritty, far more vicious, using that strength of his that he's built up. Meanwhile, Golden Phoenix, far more traditional high flyer luchador, able to just use that ability to, you know, he is graceful around that ring. It's remarkable. But Leo, oh, far more utilitarian, far more looking to just dish out pure brutality and vicious assaults on his opponents. Now, a very quick kick out there. It was only a one count. Golden Phoenix gets right back up. And, oh, look at that. Oh, my God. Wow. A bit of high flying. We haven't seen this in a long time from Leo. Leo a lot more grounded than his former tag team partner. But it looks like Leo is showing that he hasn't forgotten those old tricks from back in the day. And Leo now. Oh, 450 splash. It took a lot out of Leo as well, but it took way more out of the Golden Phoenix now. One. Only a one count. And I think that is because Leo had to recover. Took too long to make that pin. Oh, now look at this. Oh, right to the back of the head. Golden Phoenix gets out of the ring. Makes his way back in the ring. But Leo chasing after. Golden Phoenix going to chase after as well. Hurricane Rana and landing onto that padded concrete floor. And Leo now trash-talking the Golden Phoenix. Wonder what he must have been saying right there. What could he have been saying to his former tag team partner? And again, a third time. Oh my god, I think he's going to keep going. Oh, what a soul butt right there. And oh, a clothesline from the Golden Phoenix. The Golden Phoenix has just realised he needs to get back into the ring. Count of six. Leo's back in as well now. Oh, and you saw there Golden Phoenix was started saying something to Leo. And then, but Leo wasn't going to hear it. Leo was not hearing any of it. And now, setting up Golden Phoenix into the Tree of Woe. What is Leo planning? Oh my goodness, Golden Phoenix trying to get himself free, trying to get himself up so he can unlatch those legs. But Leo has it right where he wants and pounces onto the Golden Phoenix, goes for that pin once again. Two, three. And the first match in the series of seven goes to Leo. My, oh my, that was a, what a match. Leo and the Golden Phoenix really showing what they're capable of. You had some great stuff from both competitors. The high flying from the Golden Phoenix was impressive. But the brutality of Leo was what won over in the end. Leo, no, like very little wasted motion, just kept going and going and going. The only time he bothered to show any showmanship was almost as if he was just getting into the head of the Golden Fiend, showing that he has not forgotten their old days when they were both the big high flyers of Intense Wrestling's tag division. Leo now, likely feeling good getting that first win. There's six matches to go, however, but winning the main event. If you enjoyed this video, remember to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And we'll see you next time.